Julie's here, and I am with Diana from Being Mommy with Style. So we are at the YouTube Mommy Meetup conference in Chicago, and everybody's filming a bunch of videos, and we decided that we would do a tag for my channel. We just filmed a back-to-school video over on her channel, so make sure you go check that out. I'll link it down below. But we're going to try the
17 random questions
today. Yes,
totally random. Yes. So the first question is, how did you get your YouTube username?
All right, well, mine is kind of corny, but both of my kids' names start with a K, so K Square, and I'm like, oh, K Square.
Cute. I love it. That's cute. I love it. For me, I don't know, it was kind of random. It was honestly just really random. I think we'll leave it at that, because otherwise it would be a super long story. I was just thinking of names, and it's one that I really liked. So my Bigs for Bubbles, that was a forum name I used a lot, but then it somehow turned into Beingmommywithstyle. I apparently love bee names. I don't know. Number two is, if you could change your name to anything, what would it be and why?
See, my name is so unique that I really like it, and I like the story behind it. My name, my parents made it up. The first two letters are the first two letters of my dad's name, and the last three are the first three letters of my mom's name. So I like my name, but I guess I really like the name, like Isabella. I like Gianna. I like names like that.
The end of name.
Yeah, yeah. I like my name.
I've always really liked my name too. Like, my full name is Diana Elizabeth, and so it's always like the, you know, English royalty. It's always, I've always loved the sound of it together. So I don't know that I necessarily would change it either, but I don't know. I don't know. I like it. Diana's sometimes kind of old fashioned. But I don't know. Annabelle is coming to mind. I don't know why. Like, I don't know why Annabelle. I like names with L's in them. I have some weird hang up on not beginning with L, names with L's in them. So I'd probably go with something that had an L in the middle of it somewhere. Number three is, if you could go back in time and give your younger self advice, what would it be and why?
I would probably tell myself not to be so hard on myself.
Yeah, that's a good one. Like, just don't stress about the little things. Because you get so caught up into, like, worrying about, like, oh, what about this? What about that? And honestly, just roll with it. Just be yourself and roll with it. It's all good. Number four, I don't think either of us are going to know. How old were you when you first learned how to blow a bubblegum bubble?
I have no idea.
It's like, how random. These are random questions.
I know for sure my mom didn't let me chew gum till I was like 9 or 10, so probably sometime around then.
When we went to college. Yeah. I don't know either. Sometime in grade school. I think I was probably pretty happy about it when it did happen, but don't remember how old I was. Number five was, what did you want to be when you were little?
Oh, I always wanted to be a teacher, so I kind of did it, so that
worked out. That all worked out. I bounced around so much as a kid. I wanted to be a doctor. I wanted to be an astronaut. I wanted to be an astronaut for a really long time. I went to space camp like 3 times. I was like super, super into it. And I was also really into dance, so I wanted to do something with dance. I did own a dance studio for a while, so I kind of fulfilled that.
Yeah.
But then I randomly ended up in business. Just random.
Totally random.
This is a random question. This is perfect, because I had Starbucks for breakfast this morning. What do you order at Starbucks?
I always get some sort of cold tea. Or if it's the winter, I get like a peppermint mocha.
Yes, those are good. I like the peppermint white ones. Those are really good. And this morning, I ordered the, see if I can get this right, the mango black tea lemonade. And it was
awesome.
Really good. Yes, like, I want another one. Like, after we get done filming later today for lunch, like, I want another one. That, and then also in the winter, the peppermint white mocha. Perfect. Seven, what's the hardest you've ever laughed?
I don't know. I'm always laughing.
I laugh a lot too. I know, it's the same. So yeah, it happens all the time. Number eight, if you could play any musical instrument, what would it be and why?
I would play the piano. I just think it's classic. I think it's like beautiful, so I would definitely play the piano.
probably a little known fact about me, so people are going to find this out on your channel. I actually played a number of instruments when I was younger, and I had piano lessons, and then I did like all the brass instruments, and I particularly did French horn, and I wish I would have stuck with it a little bit more, because I actually wasn't horrible at it. But it was kind of a cool instrument to play, so I would say go back to playing the French horn, which now I could probably not do anything on it, but, you know, what are you going to do? Number 9, what's your favorite thing to do when you're upset?
This is going to sound crazy, but I like to clean. I don't know why.
Come to my house when you're upset.
I don't know why, and it's funny because my husband will come home, and if something's, like, especially clean, like, shining, he's like, what happened? I don't know why, but, like, I guess when I'm cleaning, I clear my mind because I just, like, talk to myself in my brain. So, like, I scrub, and I think, and it kind of pops me down.
I wish I had that as my answer. I do not. I don't know. If I'm upset about something, I'm one of those people where I just go to bed and pull the covers over my head and I'm done. Like, when I've hit my limit, like, I'm just go to sleep. Just turn off for a little bit.
Yeah.
10, what's your favorite movie?
Oh, my favorite movie from forever ago has always been Never Been Kissed, and I could probably recite the entire movie to you, but now, I see so many movies, so I don't know. I really liked Ant-Man. We went to see that in the movie theater.
I've seen that, yeah.
And it was really good. It was funny. And we saw Fantastic Four, and that was pretty good, too. So, like, that's, like, the recent one.
Yeah, those are good.
Yeah, but, Yeah, Never Been Kissed. My favorite.
I would say Disney specific movie wise, Sleeping Beauty. I've always loved that one for some reason. Like the whole pink, blue. But then just overall, the movie Chasing Liberty. It's like a really like not well known movie. It's got Mandy Moore in it when she was younger, and she like goes across Europe and falls in love. I just love those movies where they like randomly fall in love. So Chasing Liberty was always a favorite of mine. The next question is, what's one food you cannot live without?
Potatoes. Yeah. I was actually put on a strict diet because I have pre-diabetes, and they told me no potatoes, and I told the doctor that was not going to happen. I was like, I have to at least have a potato, like, you know, once a week. Like, just, you know, even a small one. I have to have potatoes. It doesn't matter if it's mashed, fried, baked. I just love potatoes.
The potato. For me, it's anything sweet. I love sweet stuff. That's my downfall. So I would say, of course, we all know I love macarons, just saying, but anything sweet. If someone told me you couldn't have bread, oh, I'm a breadaholic. So I think it's like rolls. So like bread and rolls and anything sweet. Which feeds right into the next question. What's your favorite dessert?
My favorite dessert is cheesecake. I love cheesecake. Any kind of cheesecake.
I love cheesecake too. But macarons, I have to answer that. But yeah, I love cheesecake too. Favorite pizza topping. We had pizza for dinner last night.
Yeah,
so what'd you get on your pizza?
I actually had spinach on my pizza, and that's actually my favorite.
Awesome.
I like spinach, black olives, like green peppers. I like stuff.
And I got mushrooms on mine, so I guess that's my favorite topping. The next question is, would you rather have the superpower to read minds or the superpower to be invisible?
I think read minds. I think just because I'm self-conscious, so I would want to know what people are thinking.
I know, I'm the same way. I'm like, what are they really thinking? I think I would want to know that too. Yeah, that's the good one. Number 15, what did you do for your last birthday?
Oh,
like how old are we again? Hold on a second, I gotta do some math.
I have no idea. We probably just stood home because it's in October and we don't know. Oh no, actually I do remember. I went to a funeral for my birthday last year. Yeah, my husband's uncle passed away, so we were in New Jersey for my birthday last year.
I honestly don't remember. Everything after 21's a blur. I don't really remember any birthdays after that. Let's see, how old am I? Like 32? I don't know. We were probably at home just doing something with the kids. I literally don't remember. We usually go to like a Mexican restaurant because my birthday's Cinco de Mayo. But I don't think we did this year for some reason. I don't remember. So, I don't remember. Apparently nothing memorable. Sorry if somebody did something memorable because I don't remember. Number 16 is, if you had one personal selfish wish, what would it be and why?
I don't know. know, selfish. I'm like not a selfish person by nature, so I can think of a million things for everyone else, and I don't think, I don't know, maybe that I wouldn't gain weight at all if I ate with them.
Want that one too. I'm going to eat anything I want and not have to worry about it. Yeah, that's a good one. I don't know if this is selfish, but like for everyone to always be nice, like, you know what I mean? Like to not have to worry about, like, you know, people's intentions. I don't know if that's necessarily selfish or just wishful thinking, but
I don't think it's very selfish.
I think it, like, I just wish everyone would always be nice to you. Like, or it always have good intentions,
right.
I think is the thing, you know? Number 17, we're not going to be able to answer this unless you know something about Pokemon. These are literally random. Like, if you were a Pokemon, what would you be called and what would you look like? I don't even, let's just say cartoon character. If you were a cartoon character, what would you be called and what would you look like?
I don't know. I'm hoping I would look like a beautiful Disney princess. That's like everybody's dream.
Yeah. I literally said that in a different video today. I did. I was like, I want to be Cinderella.
Yeah. Yeah. Or a fairy, because I was always one of those people that was like, I love Tinkerbell because she's not a princess, even though, you know, I love the princess.
And she's got a tooth, too. You know? But she can pull it off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I would probably look like myself, but like a lot thinner, and that would be nice.
Oh.
I don't know what I'd be called. Princess Delice.
Princess Delice. Right? So we love our names, so we don't want to change our names at all. Princess Annabelle. I would probably be some sort of princess fairy as well. I also really like the fairies. They're just fun and fun.
Yeah.
Be someone fun. So that was all of the 17 questions on the 17 random question tag, and we'll make sure somehow that they're linked down below or something if you guys want to do this tag also.
Yeah, and they're definitely random.
Definitely random.
Yes. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you check out our video over on Diana's channel and subscribe to her if you're not already, and check out all the other wonderful videos from this conference. We were having a blast. Everybody's filming, everybody's just laughing. It's like we made real life friends.
I know, it's like I know you. I've seen you on my computer.
Yeah.
It's great.
It's awesome. So I will see you guys in another video.
Bye.